This is the Transformers Generations War for Cybertron Trilogy Earthrise Cybertronian Villains 2-pack of Skywarp and Thundercracker. Oh my goodness, I am so happy to actually have this set in hand. Let's give you a quick look at the packaging. Here you go. And I'm not sure if this is the variant, because I was under the impression that Skywarp was here and Thundercracker was here, but I don't know. So this could be the variant. I picked up this set at Kal-El Collectibles. Please go check out their Facebook page. Kal-El Collectibles has a massive inventory of all these toys, action figures, model kits, and other collectibles that's perfect for every collector. And here are Thundercracker and Skywarp out of packaging, and boy do they look great. I love how they turned out. Now these two were the sort of posse or backup squad of Starscream back in the cartoon, the 1980s Generation 1 cartoon. And speaking of Starscream, here they are with the usurper himself, Starscream, and the trio of the Generation 1 Seekers are now complete. And I like how the colors turned out. Skywarp is your usual purple and black colors. He's accurate to the toy in the cartoon. Now Thundercracker is a shade of blue or a tint of blue in between toy accuracy and cartoon accuracy. So it's like the middle ground for blue. But either way, they look absolutely fantastic. And I will not be surprised if somewhere down the line, either in Earthrise or in the next installment of the War for Cybertron trilogy, Hasbro is going to repack and milk these three figures, repack them into a Seeker set, and maybe do them in the cel-shaded animation colors, much like what they did with Megatron and Optimus Prime. I think that would be great. It's only in their best interest, because these molds, despite what people are saying about them just being an oversized version of the classics mold, I like it. And I think Hasbro is going to repaint the heck out of these molds, because they look absolutely wonderful. I thought the paint apps turned out great. Purple with blue, the red and white colors on Thundercracker. Even the silver paint apps came out great. There's hardly any quality issues. I personally think I got lucky, because knowing my history with Hasbro, a lot of the times these things are going to have some issue or one another. It's just my bad luck with them. But I got absolutely lucky. These things came out wonderful. And I've tried all the joints. The joints are quite stiff. There's still no mold degradation. One of the things I noticed, though, in terms of the mold, is I don't know if it's a correction done by Hasbro or if it's mold degradation or something like that. But particularly with Skywarp, I found it a little bit easier to detach the chest piece right here when you're doing the transformation. I don't know if there was some warping done on these two tabs or anything like that, but it was definitely a much easier task to do than it was with Starscream. The same was true for Thundercracker. And now comparing them with their Siege counterparts, here is Thundercracker with the Cybertronian mode of Thundercracker. They look great. The shade of blue is near identical. If at all, the Earthrise is a tint darker than the Siege version, but they still look absolutely fantastic. I wish the Siege version had some more silver paint apps on where the gray parts are. But yeah, it looks really, they look great. I was thinking of, after getting all of the Earthrise Seekers, I'd go and sell off my Cybertronian or Siege Seekers, but no, I think I'm gonna hang on to them, because they still look great. And here is Skywarp with his Siege counterpart. This one was an exclusive set, came with two other battle masters, but again, very similar in design and motif. The Siege version, albeit, has a sort of a gray hue about him. It's not entirely black, but that's fine. I wish they had made him black, even if it was a metallic type of black color, but it doesn't matter. The gunmetal gray and silver and the purple on the Siege version, I think, complements the Earthrise Skywarp when you put them both on the shelf. They look absolutely fantastic together. And here is a group shot of everybody, including the Siege version of Starscream. So let's have one last look at these two in robot mode before we move on into jet mode. And they are the exact same mold as Starscream. So we're not going to show off transformation because you've already seen that in my Starscream video. Here they are. And once again, here with Starscream, let's talk about the differences in the head sculpt. As you can see right here, the facial expression between them are quite different, with Starscream having that scowling look, and then Thundercracker with the poker face, and Skywarp with the screaming expression on his face. A bit of an intermission before we go into their jet modes. This is the insert that came with the two-pack, and I don't see any planets anywhere except for this streak of red. I guess we'll know the significance of that once we get the entire Earthrise map. And here are Thundercracker and Skywarp in their jet modes. I never grow tired of seeing these two Seekers in their colors. I love it. If I'm gonna give a comment or so, I just wished that they could have used a glossier type of plastic, the one they used for Transformers Universe Sideswipe, that metallic glossy plastic with a little bit of flake in it. I think that would have made this a stellar set. As it is, it's a bit of a downer. And as you can see, there are some discoloration in the plastic. This one is a little bit of a faded blue. This one is a nice cerulean blue and all that. So, and you get this light baby blue. So there's a lot of unevenness in the colors. Had they used that glossy finish, we could have made this a more homogeneous look. Same with Skywarp. As you can see, there are dull black pieces here and there. It's fine. It's just a little bit of a downer, but not a deal breaker. Definitely not a deal breaker. And I'm still really, really happy with the way these two turned out, both in robot mode and in alt mode. And here they are with Boss Seeker Starscream. Great, amazing G1 alt modes. Here is Thundercracker with his Siege counterpart. And here is Skywarp with his Siege counterpart. And just so we can have everybody in the shot, here they both are with Starscream and Starscream Siege counterpart. And so some final thoughts on this set. I think this set is essential to any Generations collector, particularly if you are trying to get all the figures for the War for Cybertron trilogy. There's so much G1 about this set, about this mold, and if you've already gotten Starscream, it is a no-brainer that you have to get the Thundercracker and Skywarp 2-pack. Now, having said that, I'm a little bit annoyed that Hasbro is still going the way of store exclusives. I mean, I do appreciate the fact that they've put both repaints in one box, in one 2-pack, so you don't have to hunt them down separately. And I'm pretty sure that's what's going to happen with the Dirge and Ramjet set once we have Thrust. And what's sad, I think, to realize is that 2-pack is most likely going to be another store exclusive. I wouldn't be surprised if it were another Target exclusive. And with all that, because it is an exclusive, it is scalper bait and hoarder bait, and everyone is going to make a buck off of it, trying to hoard it. This is a highly anticipated, heavily in-demand product. You know that people are going to take advantage of that. Being that it is a Target exclusive, there are places in the world where there are no Target stores, like here in Manila, in the Philippines, and in Asia. There are no Target stores. We're left at the mercy of hobby shops who are just going to get it and import it, maybe from Hasbro suppliers in Asia, maybe from the US. And I kid you not, the going retail price of this set at hobby shops here in Manila is at least $80 to about $95. And I'm pretty sure once stocks come in, hobby shops and other online sellers, I wouldn't be surprised if they start selling it for $100 on retail. That's just retail. That's not even the scalper prices yet. On eBay, scalpers are selling this one for $110, $120 a pop. So it's ridiculous. And I'm trying to implore Hasbro, if Hasbro is listening, I wish they wouldn't put the main characters as store exclusives or as channel exclusives. I mean, special odd characters or characters that are for the hardcore collectors, I think that's okay to be put on as a store exclusive. But a main character such as Starscream or Thundercracker and Skywarp, I mean, Hasbro has started to realize that they cannot alienate their fan base, their collectors. Because once collectors realize that it is near, next, close to impossible to complete the line, people are just going to give up on the line. Take, for example, this Skywarp. This Skywarp was, I don't know if it was a Walmart exclusive or an Amazon exclusive, but a lot of people never got the Siege Skywarp. And if you're Hasbro, you're thinking, the way you should be thinking is Starscream, Thundercracker, and Skywarp should always come together. How difficult is it to get that in your brains? I mean, you've been doing this for 35 years, going 40 years. You haven't figured out that collectors, if there is a Thundercracker, they're going to want a Skywarp. If there's a Skywarp, they're going to want a Thunder. If there's a Starscream, they are going to want the other two Seekers. Because if you watch the cartoon, these three are always together. Given the fact that Starscream, perhaps a bigger character on the show, it doesn't preclude the fact that most collectors are going to want all three Seekers. So, can we make a petition to Hasbro and Takara Tomy to always release these three figures as a three-pack and don't make them store exclusives? For crying out loud. Sorry for the rant, but it's just been very frustrating to collect all three Seekers. And don't get me started on the Classics line. I mean, that Skywarp and Ultra Magnus was just so ridiculously overpriced and difficult to find. And there was a time in my life years ago that I felt that I could not move on with a Classics line unless I got that Skywarp and Ultra Magnus. And I ended up paying $140 for that set at a convention. I mean, that's just ridiculous. I'm trying to understand how Hasbro's trying to listen to the fans. They've been doing so with the Black Series, with the Marvel Legends, and they're trying to re-release the figures that have just skyrocketed on eBay. So that's great. But if I may say one last point, if you don't want the prices to skyrocket, stop alienating your fans by putting the highly in-demand characters, figures, as store exclusives, as like part of a set that nobody wants, or as an Asian exclusive, or as a North American exclusive, or as a European exclusive. Don't make it an exclusive. Make it available at mass retail, and trust me, there'll be very few scalpers to take advantage of that. Anyway, I've said too much. It's an amazing set. The set is going to get a 9.5 out of 10 for me. I did have some issues with it, but it's near perfect, and it is an absolute must-have for all generations collectors, particularly that the scale is great and we're getting a great mold. And I wish everybody the best of luck truly hunting this down. Don't pay scalper prices for this set. You will get it. Law of averages. Sooner or later, you're going to score one, and just be patient. With that, I'd like to thank everybody for joining me in this review. Let me know in the comments what you think of this two-pack, and if you agree with me that they shouldn't be exclusives, and if you agree with me that all three Seekers should always be sold as a three-pack. Hit me up in the comment section below, and as always, hit that notification bell so you never miss out on any of my latest video reviews. If it's your first time on this channel, please subscribe. Thanks for watching. Kal-El Collectibles. It is the only hobby shop where product service and delivery is just super.